Hey, what's up guys? So I'm on the latest beta of El Capitan, which is beta 8, and I did a video on disk utilities before, but I kind of wanted to come back and do one again because I had a lot of questions about the changes. So not just in looks, but functionality, disk utility has changed quite a bit from its predecessor in Yosemite. And one of the very first big things that I noticed was the lack of repairing permissions and stuff like that. So I kind of wanted to explain that. And then the first aid repair I wanted to show you guys. And then, of course, USB external hard drives, stuff like that. So as it stands, there is currently no RAID support. Now, RAID drives will work. So if you had pre-partitioned drives from previous builds, they will function. I've tested this, but I'm unable to actually create using the disk utilities a RAID. Now, you can actually create a RAID partition, either a stripe or if you want to do a RAID 6 for duplication. You can create this with terminal, and I'll actually make another video on how to show you guys just a brief how to do a striped RAID, because that would be the most popular as people use that for speed. So that's been removed as well. Now the reason they removed the disk permission thing, and I know a lot of people are like, oh my god, you can't repair the disk permissions, it's actually now done during the software updates. And realistically, that's all it needs to be done. It's not something that needs to be run all the time, unless you guys are for some reason, you know, changing file permissions, which at that point you could use the terminal command, the chmod or chmod, you know, to correct the permissions and set them properly. So the disk permission thing really wasn't a big deal for me. I wasn't too upset about that, as some of you were, but it's not going to be that big of a loss. It's done each update. There'll be more updates in the future, so your drive will always be refreshed. And I think that's better that it's done that way versus the user having to do it, because a lot of users don't even know what we're talking about right now. The next thing is the external drives. RAID obviously is not there, but we can disconnect drives. I'll get an error, plug them back in. So you can see all of the different options I wanted to go through. First was first aid. First aid, if you run it on a drive that's live, it will only do its live mode. So it won't do like a deep, you can see right here, verifying in live mode. If there's repairs that it needs to make, like bad blocks or something like that, it'll actually ask you to reboot from a separate partition and then run it again. Mine will show fine here, which I can demonstrate here. So I can run first aid over this, and it won't run in live mode because it can actually unmount the drive, which you'll see the drive beginning to unmount here. And then it'll still perform the same checks that it used to. So there's no worries here of any loss of functionality. Again, you can't repair disk permissions. As for creating partitions, I was playing with this as well. So you can still do multiple partitions. You actually use this animation here. So I could add two or three, and we get a pie. It's actually kind of neat. I really like how this was set up. So basically you can adjust your chart here to how many different partitions. Each one, as you highlight, changes here, so you could rename them. So I could do one here as one, you can be two, you could be three, and then you can be number four. And this is just as a prime example. So as I jump through all the different partitions that can be created, we could do some as FAT32 or MS-DOS. Maybe we have a Linux machine, so we'll do one as an extended FAT, and then we'll keep one as the OS. You can apply, the changes will be done, and the drive will be resized. So a lot of the functionalities are still there. We're going to see all the drives start appearing. And so that's kind of disk utilities more in depth. I really haven't found anything else that's super unique or hidden features. I might try to unlock the debug mode, as I know there's a debug menu just kind of hidden in it. But so there you guys go, that's the new disk utilities. You can see here the disk drives are now being created. Here's 1, 2, 3, and 4. and you can see all the volumes are showing here, and now it'll just finish up. So anyways, did I hopefully cover everything for you guys? Make sure you comment in the section below, let me know, and rate the video. Definitely leave a like for me. And yeah, so that's the new disk utilities in El Capitan, that's right. Anyways, thanks for watching. Rate and comment and subscribe to the channel. We'll see you guys again next time. Cheers.